Hey, what's up, guys? So I did it again. I didn't press record, so that's why it looks like my news has been read, because I did start reading it and I did start talking about it and wasn't recording because, you know, that's a cool thing to do. Anyway, I'll just pretend like I didn't and, well, no, I'll just tell you what I said. So I said, hey, guys, I finished The Road Less Traveled. That's why my Final Fantasy 15 party is looking so cool and awesome right here and up front and center. Hope you guys were able to complete that journey as well. It was a little fun thing to do on a week that didn't have too much going on otherwise, except for that, obviously, the equipment enhancements, which I'm behind on because, and then I felt you know, sad about it, like I'm letting myself down because I'm not enhancing my weapons because I'm instead running all of these guys through the Chamber of Experience because I ran out of back doors. Okay, anyway, but if it's helpful at all to know, we've got so much gear now that helps with that, that increases the experience gained. So anyway, I already talked about that in the last video, so I won't say it again. But, going into the news, it did the dumb thing where it shot up the Afterglow news at me. I didn't, in my attempt to go through the news just a second ago without pressing record, I didn't actually get to that one yet. And that's the one that popped up in my face, and I, with one eyeball, kind of blurred, exited out of it real fast, but it still marks it as red. I don't like it when it does that. I wish it would just, I get what they're doing, pop-ups and all that. Okay, so I think where we started was here at maintenance, and I informed you guys that there will be maintenance on Wednesday. I know, it's surprising. But if you didn't know, the game will be inaccessible during maintenance, so plan accordingly, right? You know, just saying, be careful. Don't let that catch you off guard. It might happen every week, but doesn't mean you remember, right? Okay, so, we then looked and we saw that the Empress Supreme is indeed arriving. Remember Morgana? Well, she's back. And we were supposed to get this trial, I think, I don't know, a couple weeks ago or something. But then, like, something happened. They wanted to rework it. They weren't happy with whatever was going on. So, anyway, here she is. We get her now. She's a powerful woman who is absolutely convinced that she is the embodiment of righteousness. As usual, I'm not going to read through this for you guys because you can read it yourselves. Or hire someone to read it. Sorry, I say this every time, but then I realize that whenever I tell you I'm not going to read it, I always feel bad for, yeah, if you do need somebody to read it for you. There's nothing wrong with that. Okay, moving on. Empress Supreme Morgana, as beautiful as she is dangerous, just so you know, she's just as beautiful and just as dangerous as she was last time. Or even if she's not, those things will correlate. Her danger directly correlates to her beauty level. So, I don't know. I should stop. Okay. Morgana uses powerful elemental attacks. Okay. And exploit her weakness against light. Like, remember last time we used Echlina. But now we have Kimono Fina. Well, I don't have her, but maybe you have her. So that's an option. And, of course, we have light gear, weapons, and all that stuff, so you can pretty much make anyone a light damage dealer, right? Mm-hmm. Watch out for her powerful arcane explosion ability, which deals a large amount of fixed magical damage to all her enemies. Kubo! All her enemies is a strange way to just say AoE damage, right? AoE fixed magical damage? Alright, anyway, so she can be fought in Pro, ELT, and LGD, so I'll be winning Pro. Probably not the ELT or the LGD anytime soon, because, you know, I just probably struggled too much in The Road Less Traveled than I needed to. But she's gonna be around in that little vortex spot where the egg is, I believe, because it's one of those battles where you have to, like, keep changing your team in order to reap the rewards. So she's gonna be hanging out with the egg guys, and I haven't, you know, done all the different levels with him either, so I think we have time. I don't think that they're leaving the vortex anytime soon, so that's good. The rewards look pretty cool. Just looking at the pictures. That's all I'm doing right now is looking at pictures. Super Trustmaster tickets is great. That little emblem thing, if you like to brag about your accomplishments, that's there for you. 5-star EX tickets. I'm sitting on two of those right now, waiting until somebody I really, really want comes out, because on the off chance that I'll pull them with my EX ticket, which is such a stupid, impossible thing to do, but hey, right? You know, why not? Unique equipment, Imperial Heals. Okay, so this is what, like, you know, the Catastrophic set and all the other sets, the set of Virtue, even those. This lady, Morgana, is kind of a little bit warped in her idea of virtue. I mean, I know that she thinks she's doing the right thing by killing everybody, but, you know, I don't know. So do the Nazis. It's problematic, right? So she's not a good girl. She's not nice. She's pretty bad. Anyway, there you go. You get a lot of magic and spirit if you get all this stuff together. You can go look at the actual numbers and add them all up in your own time. ELT gives you the Scepter of Justice, which is magic 60% when equipped with a rod. So that's better, I think, than Rod Mastery, I'm guessing. Engulfing Light boosts magic by 80% when equipped with a light elemental weapon. So throw that on Elena, maybe, unless you have a better build for her that doesn't need it. Good for you. Bonus 30% if you bring these guys along. I think that means that they get, like, better hit points and stats or something. Alright. Scorn of the Wicked Moon. Ooh, you can get a 5-star summon ticket for it. Or select summon, I should say. And when I looked at this the first time, when I didn't have the actual record button on, I gasped with horror because I do not like the Bloody Moon at all. I don't care for him one bit. Anybody who saw me go up against him in one of my earlier videos probably just, I don't know, had to go take some time away and just look at videos of puppies and kittens after that, because it was probably atrocious and really painful to watch. He's got the stupid apostles, stupid Bloody Moon apostles who just, like, fly around and are idiotic and, like, you can only attack me with light, and oh, I'm just weak against fire. So it's like you can never attack all of them at once, and it's very frustrating. And if you attack, I don't know, just didn't like it. It was terrible. It's recommended to use non-elemental magic attacks. Oh, wait a second. So I now have my new ace in the hole. I now have a High Seraph Ultima, who does non-elemental magic damage, and she can do that, like, quad off the bat. So actually, you know, she's like, that was a great add, you know, and I would not have 7-starred her at that point in the game if I had not been trying to build a party, a Final Fantasy Tactics party for on the Road Less Traveled. To take down Grand Seraph Ultima. So actually, like, you know, being kind of like forced into 7-starring her, not forced, like, you know, I wanted to, of course, but she was not on my list. She, like, my prioritization of, like, who, what SCMRs I'm trying to get, and obviously, like, I'm strapped for girl, so I was not prioritizing her, and I did it for that trial, and I'm so glad I did, because she turns out to be, like, a super, super beast of a beast, magic damage dealer. So, that might be a good choice for this. I would probably try it first if I ever try this. I'll probably try this in, like, 9 months when my party's even stronger, or, like, we have even stronger people. I don't know. What's the point of me going up against this now, right? It's just gonna be hideous. So, anyway, that's the Bloody Moon. You can get some Lapis, you can get the Artemis Bow, but, like, who uses bows? I don't know. I mean, I have Aang, but, he has his own bow, so I don't know. But that's a cool bow. It's got a lot of stat on it, lots of stats. All those things, 5-star Thomas, yeah, so, Chamber and the Dignit, if you want to see this pool. Afterglow. This is the thing I looked at with one eye. Oh, story event. So, yay, we need one of these. Sadly, I don't think it's gonna be enough to give me the Kekthars and the Gill Snappers that I really, really need in life. But I do need Chris as well. And usually I get some pretty good stuff during these events. So I'm excited. And it's Sol. Oh my goodness. Okay, this is probably a spoiler, but do you see the reflection? Okay, so don't tell me anything. Stop telling me things because I am behind in the story. You're not really. I'm not bad mouthing anybody that has ever commented on in my page. But in my head, I'm thinking about people trying to talk about the story event and being like, oh yeah, you know, that's a blah, blah, blah. I don't want to know. I'm not caught up with the story. I like to keep the story on back burner in those moments when I need to get a bunch of lapis because somebody came out and I'm not prepared and I need the lapis to pull on them. So I kind of like keep my distance from the end of the story so that I have that option. So I don't know what's up with Sol lately, but I know that I was starting to really like him. Where I was in the story, just I liked his like little snarky little attitude and just kind of like kind of like not giving any F's and all that. But I'm sorry, I just said F's, but you never know who has kids around, so trying to do you guys favors. Bonus stages have appeared. Okay, we all know all this. Okay, so nothing new here. Blah, 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 Chris. Oh, what's that? Limited edition or limited equipment rod. Me. Float sandals. Cool. Try out new characters. Eclipsa. They're kind of weird looking. Like a rabid little rodent creature. Human thing. All right. Yeah, all these names I have to say. Portira, Heliarch, and then Sol. So Heliarch, spoiler alert or not spoiler alert, looks like that person in the reflection. Just saying. Sorry, I'm not trying to spoil anything. Anyway, I like Sol a lot. I can't pull. I don't have the resources to pull for Sol, and he's gonna be in our main, like we can use a select summon on him or whatever. So here's his banner if you do want to pull a rate up or something for this trust Moogle summon. Oh, 2,000 for a 5+1. That's new. That's just like, oh, I just want to spend like 2,000 lapis just test my luck. So then you might do that, and then you might look out. You might not. But oh, Sol's been globally upgraded. He's got these STMRs and this TMR robe and an accessory. Magical 70 is pretty high, but we have some other high ones too, right? I don't know. Enable Ever Shining Stone. Reduce magic point consumed by abilities. Alright. Deal dark damage to all enemies and power points that we use. And his global upgrade. Reduce all those things. So it's like a little resistance break or something like that. I don't know. Oh, and then it enables quadruple obliteration. So quadcast, I'm assuming. Alright. Interesting. And then there's these people. You can read through this or look at it if you just want to admire the pictures. Whatever you want to do. She's got a global upgrade. And anyway, there's all that stuff. So that was cool news. I'm always happy to see a new character. FFBE story event, those are always fun. In other news, I'm trying a new flavor from LaCroix today, or LaCroix, I don't know how you guys say it, but hibiscus flavor. It's kind of strange. And it kind of tastes like Nerds, you know, the candy Nerds. Kind of tastes like Nerds to me. Which is strange because there's no hibiscus flavor in Nerds, but it's weird. It's supposed to be floral, but it's a little bit sweet. Like, I don't know. Anyway, that's the news in sparkling water. Anyhow, nothing really else to talk on, so I will let you all go. Anybody excited about those big scary trials coming up? Ugh, I don't know. Pretty intimidating and off-putting for me. That's why I like these little trial marathons because they're actually doable. I got a lot of guys upgraded in the meantime to their 6-star forms, so that's fun too. Play around with some people I haven't played around with. So anyway, get excited for Soul if that's what excites you. Just a few more days and some super boring days coming up in the meantime. Go get those items worked on if that's what you want. All right, cheers.